Welcome to iLecture Online. Here we have an example where we're not actually working out the numbers, but it gives you a good perspective on what a Monte Carlo simulation is. And this is how we actually use it in one of our applications. Let's say that we have a project, and the project depends upon five specific tasks that need to be executed. So we identify all the possible outcomes. So the task in this case will be the outcomes. And then we have to project the duration in months for each of those tasks. The low estimate would be the number of months for each of those five tasks. Here's the most likely estimate, and here's the high estimate. And then we can assign a probability of what we think is the likelihood that that will occur. In other words, there's a 20% probability we'll be able to do task A in 2 months. There's a 50% probability we'll be able to do it in 3 months, and there's a 20% probability we'll be able to do it in 4 months. And so we can go down the line for each of the tasks, estimate the low estimate, the high estimate, and the most likely estimate, and assign a probability that that will occur in such a way. Notice that if everything works perfect, and we have the least amount of time for each of the tasks, the total project will last 18 months. The most likely projection is 26 months, and the high projection is 36 months. Typically, we have estimates that say that we don't think it will take longer than that. It's almost impossible to take longer than that. We'll have the very high end where we realize we have 100% probability it will not take more than X number of months, and that's typically how it's done. But what's most important is we don't really care so much about the 0 or the 50% or the 100%. We care about a reasonable probability that the project will be done within a certain amount of time, and that reasonable probability will be somewhere between 80 or 90%, somewhere in that neighborhood. And so what's the possibility or the probability at the 90% level, how long the project will take, what will be the number of months? And so what we can then do is we can graph that out. After we run the Monte Carlo simulation, we'll assign numbers, random numbers to each of those, run the simulation many thousands of times, and then we can see how everything develops, and then we can come up with an estimate that says we have a 90% probability the project will not last for more than 35 months, and then we can plan for that with a very good probability that we'll be successful in completing it. 90% probability is then pretty good. We don't necessarily care about the 100% probability because we want to push as much as we can to have an almost certainty that it'll be done within 35 months, and we don't have to worry about any longer than that. It's very unlikely we'll get it done in 18 months. Everything has to be just perfectly right, and that's usually not the case. If we care about the 50% probability, then in this case we can see that it will take about 26 months, but 50% probability is not something you want to tell your customer saying, hey, we're going to be done in 26 months, when you'll have a 50-50 chance that you'll actually be successful. You may want to tell your customer, I'm pretty sure I can get it done in 35 months. I ran my Monte Carlo simulations and I have a 90% probability that we'll be done with the project after 35 months. And that is how this is used.